I fell in love with Grenada the first time I was ever in Grenada. People were so nice, and the place is so beautiful and peaceful. And I ended up making a habit of coming here for the last 17 years or so, every year, sometimes for a whole year, sometimes for just part of a year. We are the smallest chocolate company in the entire world, probably the only solar-powered one, and I'm fairly sure we're the only small-scale chocolate company that actually makes a finished, fine dark chocolate from cocoa bean, and we're the only one that does it in a cocoa-producing country.
Grenada Chocolate Company produces amazing chocolate, which is one of the most delicious I've ever tasted. It's so amazing, this very, very small company making chocolate actually on the site where it grows. No one's ever done that before. No longer in bondage, no shackles, no more chains,
they say. Freedom, yeah. The system to grow cocoa in general is it's grown by exploited farmers in the southern part of the world. It's brought to the northern part of the world and made into a fancy product to benefit the people in the northern part of the world. Now, fair trade chocolate has attempted to some extent to mitigate that by creating minimum prices required to pay for cocoa beans. Now, one problem, though, is that there's internal corruption, internal disparity of wealth and exploitation inside cocoa countries. So the price paid for that cocoa bean might be better, but it goes to a very rich landowner, doesn't affect the plight of the actual laborer. Until we know we can't advance without vision, we're still in slavery, mental slavery. My vision, when I dreamed of doing this for many years, was to create a cooperative that included cocoa farmers and chocolate makers to make fine dark chocolate right here in Grenada with the local cocoa beans, so that there would be tremendous value added to the cocoa crop in Grenada. This would and does help the local economy, it helps the tourist sector, it creates jobs, it helps the plight of all the cocoa farmers that get involved in our cooperative.
I really respect what he's doing, and I think in a way it's great inspiration for an awful lot of people, and I think could well be the way for people to go forward all around the world and wherever cocoa is grown.
What was first required in this project was to figure out how to make chocolate in a world where you can't buy machines to make chocolate on a small scale. So for over a year, we worked in Oregon at my friend Doug's house and developed a line of homemade and, in some cases, refurbished antique chocolate equipment in order to make small-scale chocolate. When we had done that, we came to Grenada and we united with my oldest friend in Grenada, Edmund Brown, and he became our third partner. One of the first things that we discovered about the cocoa here is that it's been more or less in decline. And as a result of that, cocoa farmers have been cutting corners, spending less money on their cocoa farms, and there hasn't been the addition of chemical pesticides and fertilizers. Therefore, it was very easy for us to certify our farm organic.
I had a conversation with Mott a while ago about possibly coming in and trying to help him to expand his business and maybe be silent partners, and his reaction to that was, if you want to do something like this, what I'd really like to see is for you to imitate our model here and do it somewhere else. It was a wonderful suggestion, and it also shows his idealist spirit, that he's not there to make money out of it, he's there to try and make a difference to people's lives.
ever since I dropped out of college, I became an activist, and I did various things over the years, everything from projects to help homeless people in large cities in the United States to tinkering with natural building, worked a lot with appropriate technology and solar energy, did a host of different things. I think it was Mark Twain that said, never let school get in the way of your education. You know, this project was really an experiment. It's a very, very small factory. I call it a cottage factory. Now, we're so successful, the chocolate became so popular, we're selling out. Tourist season comes in Grenada. We can't make enough, even for all the tourists that come. There's a big demand for our chocolate internationally. So what we're in the planning stages now of is creating a bigger factory, building our own building in this village as well, where we'll be able to make much more chocolate. We'll be able to export it all over the world. We'll become more profitable. Will help us with creating community projects. You know, there's endless amounts of wonderful projects that can be done to help Grenada as a country. Bye bye, baby, bye bye. Bye bye. You know I love you and that's no lie. But I find myself another bona fide. Everything I want, you can buy. Never wanna cry, never wanna shed a tear. No, no. But when I look upon them words today.